October is National Bullying Prevention Month, a campaign that unites communities nationwide to educate and raise awareness of bullying prevention. Missouri has several resources provided by the Missouri State Highway Patrol, Department of Elementary and Secondary Education, as well as the Department of Social Services to help in this area.
We provide anti-bullying programs to all ages of kids, especially the elementary and middle school age, and also the high schoolers as well, to help educate to not only the caregivers, but also the students and the kids on what bullying is and how they can not become a bully and also how they can prevent it from in the future.
Because I work in the school counseling section, most of the bullying calls are fielded to our section of the department. So have you talked to your school counselor? Have you talked to your student resource officer? Have you talked to your building administrator, your superintendent? Ultimately, the last avenue would be your school board of education. Once we get to the board of education, then we always offer the Missouri School Violence Hotline.
The Missouri School Violence Hotline creates an avenue for teachers, parents, community members, and especially students to report threats and concerns of bullying, weapons in schools, sexual harassment, cyberbullying, students that are self-harming. It gives them an avenue to either text in a report online or to call something in.
So often when those tips are made, whether it be to a teacher at the school or through any of the hotlines, we often get involved at the request of a counselor or a teacher. If it's reached a realm that's outside of the school's ability to deal with the issue.
I get calls daily that, you know, we'll go through, have you taken all these steps? And then, yes, they have. And sometimes they won't even know about the Missouri School Violence Hotline. And once you say that resource, it's almost, you can almost feel a sigh of relief. Okay, there's another avenue that I could possibly take that I could get some extra help.
You know, in essence, bullying is going to be the same throughout the years. The problem doesn't change necessarily as much as what the delivery method does 20 years ago. You know, bullying had to be done face-to-face or over a telephone. Now you still have face-to-face bullying, but now you've added in social media applications, the internet, where that can be done somewhat from the safety of a location where you're not actually have to say it face-to-face. And we also need to educate people of how not to be the bully. There's probably something going on in that bully's life also that is causing them to act the way they are. By identifying that person, we might be able to help them as well.
The Missouri Comprehensive School Counseling Program has a curriculum of 2,400 pages listed on the DESE website, and part of that curriculum deals with social-emotional pieces. If we can look at those and pull some of those pieces, those curriculum pieces off, and our counselors are able to implement that in their buildings at a young age, then hopefully we'll see less and less of bullying issues.
It's great to have those conversations with even your own kids about what to do if they're bullied or if they see someone that's being bullied and know that they have that awareness.
The key to the program is prevention. We want to minimize the incidents where this occurs, prevent it as much as possible. And by providing this education to children, they're better prepared to deal with it if they're faced with it, know what to do to avoid it, and know when to reach out and ask for help. And hopefully also get them thinking to not be that person and not become a bully.
For more information regarding school bullying and ways to report it, visit schoolviolencehotline.com.